No problem. I'll be right there.
We are setting up the logistics for the teams.
So we're going to go with Washington and Philly. We'll be in the visiting NHL and Leafs room.
All of their player movements, all of their practice times, locker room movements, and coaches' suites and suite assignments. Here at Scotiabank Arena, we have four professional locker rooms, the Raptors, the Leafs, who are the two main tenants, and then the visiting NHL room, and the press room has been converted into a locker room as well. We rotate them on a daily basis, so if we use the Leafs and the visiting NHL room for the first game at 12 noon, that locker room will then be flipped and used again for the 8 p.m. game, with the media room and the Raptors room being used as the 4 p.m. game. By doing this rotation, it allowed for teams to move in sooner than they normally would be able to. Once the third period's over is when we really start our movements. Once they are moved out, Oakview Group comes in and they certify the cleaning of the spaces. So it's about an hour for the teams to vacate and then an hour for it to be cleaned. And we get the teams playing in the 8 p.m. game or in about 4:15. For the return to play, teams were allowed to carry, I believe, 31 players. So you're almost doubling the amount of equipment that we have. It is definitely organized chaos. Here we actually only have two loading docks. We're making a joke, it's musical trucks out there. We're constantly moving trucks in and moving trucks out. We gave each team a 10 by 10 storage space, and I think each team probably took a 15 by 20 space. So it's crammed in there pretty good, but we made it work and everybody's playing nice together to make this happen. It's actually funny, when the teams move in, the first thing they do is they remove the carpet covering the Leafs logo and take a picture of all their jerseys hanging up with the Leafs carpet in the middle. It's actually been kind of funny to see guys acting like little kids taking photos like that. The Leafs were actually in their room for the first game of the tournament, and when the schedule came out, that's the way it worked out. There's really no home team in this tournament. Both teams are affected the same way. That keeps it on a level, even playing field for everybody.